Welcome you, and we receive you. You're welcome. We are going to show you around what the federal government has tried to put in place for the federal High Court. You're welcome.
The guardian of one
The only problem we have is NEPA. We don't have electricity. Even now, what we have everywhere is monitored with CCTV cameras, security cameras, even the compound, the whole compound, everywhere. What we are using now is the fan that is on. We have solar put in place. We are using solar energy. Though the fans and light, though it's a small quantity, it's just 20 kVA.
Why did you want this? You have renewable energy.
No, it's only 20 kVA. Only 20 kVA. Yes, so you cannot carry any heavy equipment. Since we came in here, it's only about 5 cases that have been filed. We came in September here. Sorry, August, during the vacation, we entered here. So the commissioning was done just a month ago. On September 24. So they dispense their matters fast, very fast. We were before at near police headquarters, nearly opposite police headquarters, customary court of appeal area. That's where we are before. Yes. We have, because our jurisdictions are not the same, they have their areas of jurisdiction, we have our own. Even though they are court of concurrent powers. Mr. Ebuche, I'm not supposed to speak to the press, but I'm just telling you this one.
Sorry, can I just...
Would like to know how long it took for this project to be completed and a vivid description of the environment. How many offices, how many rooms, whatever, all those technical information we'll need. Thank you, sir.
The cost I will not say here because I was not in the picture. It was done at the Abuja by the National Judicial Commission. So we only see people working and they worked. The project was given immediately. We came to Lokoja, Federal High Court came to Kogi State in 2010. So I think the project was awarded in 2011, and we have completed within a record time, but because the contractor was involved in an accident on his way to Abuja while communicating with the headquarters. But eventually, when I came in and he recovered, I forced him and he completed it on record time, before June. Okay, the rooms we have here, we have two courtrooms, two judges' chambers with their secretaries. We have behind there the study room for the judges, and we have an exhibit room. Down there, what we have is about three offices down by the right side as we enter. Up here, you have the library with this appartements there. And then behind, we have the accounts, three offices there, that's four, and then the admin office and the panel room, two rooms here. Then we have two cells. In the cell, we have one for this court, one for the other court. In the two cells, we have both female and male rooms because we don't want them to be together as they usually keep them in their room. And then here in the courtroom, before you enter court here, you have the dressing room for the lawyers. There we have what we call lawyers' lounge, where the lawyer have an opportunity to discuss with their clients before entering the court, or while in court, if there's something arose, you can go and then discuss with them. To have a flow of the court sitting.
Yes. No, not sure. Sorry. Tijani Mohammed.
Praise every time to come, not for them to wait for us to call them or judgment alone. They can come and cover the proceedings of court. Some of them here are waiting until they are invited to come. With that, you cannot project the court on what is doing. So your question, this place has not been fully furnished. The furnishing is still on. You can see that a lot of other things are not there. It's only coat of arms you can only see. We've tried, you can see that the flag is just as new as every other thing, but many things have to be added here. Thank you.
Mejiro in Festus, Ben Television.
That was one of the first things. As we go around for you to see, we have a big generator there. The building is there. The inverter was just to supplement. And where there is no NEPA, there's automatic conversion for that inverter to take over. And where the inverter cannot, if it is hot, the generator will be on. You can see that the windows were open when you came in order to give a good ventilation.
Let me invite the attention of members of the Good Governance Tour team to the significance of the project that we are visiting. I'm sure it's a common refrain that we all hear when the transformation agenda is mentioned. People will ask, what are you transforming? There are aspects to the transformation agenda. I'll mention two of those aspects. One is governance reforms, the other is infrastructure. Under governance reforms, which is broken down again into several other segments, you have the reform of the judiciary that will ensure a more efficient and effective judicial system. And that includes equipping the various courts and ensuring that judges or those who dispense justice have a conducive environment in which they can function. This is a clear manifestation of one of such major steps being taken for the realization of enhancing a more effective or ensuring a more effective judicial system. You can also include it under infrastructure. It is not only when you build dams and power stations and roads that you have infrastructure. The judiciary requires its own kind of infrastructure. A courtroom is critical for this purpose. A library is critical. A complex such as you have in this place is crucial. And I would like, on behalf of the Honorable Minister of Information, to commend the Ministry of Justice as well as the Judicial Service Commission for facilitating what we are seeing here. We do hope that it will be properly maintained and put to good use, and that going forward, you would have more modern equipment for recording so that you graduate into a digital system for recording your proceedings. I would like to again thank the registrar for receiving us. He said normally he doesn't speak to the press, but today he was speaking to the members of the National Good Governance Tour team. So, registrar, thank you very much.